children by his parents, Michael and Sherry, and his brother Spencer.
Number 24, Cameron Copeland. He's a right-handed pitcher from Katy, Kent Keeling. Kent has battled injuries during his two seasons at HBU. Making three appearances on the mound, he pitched a shutout inning, each against UTSA and Rhode Island last year, and was named to the Southwest Conference Commissioner's Honor Roll. Escorted by his father, Dan, ladies and gentlemen, number 37, Kent Keeling. He's a right-handed pitcher from Waxahachie, Marshall Heron. Marshall has made 22 appearances in his two seasons at HBU, posting a 4.60 ERA with 26 strikeouts. This year he's made 19 appearances, including four starts, going 2-3 with a save, a 3.70 ERA, and 25 strikeouts. Marshall tossed six strong innings for his first career win at UT Rio Grande Valley on March 13th. And threw 2.2 scoreless innings to earn the win in Thursday's opener against Stephen F. Austin. He also struck out two to pick up the save in a 5-3 win at Central Arkansas on April 7th. Escorted by his parents, Leland and Cindy, his sister Miranda, and his girlfriend Casey Basso, number 11, Marshall Heron. He is a right-hander from Caldwell, Tanner Luna. Tanner has made 10 appearances in his two seasons at HBU, posting a 5.25 ERA. This year he threw a scoreless inning each at Fresno State and at Southeastern Louisiana, and last year tossed a scoreless inning in three straight appearances in 2017 Southland Conference Tournament. Tanner pitched a scoreless ninth in a win over Central Arkansas to send the Huskies to the championship Saturday. Escorted by his father and stepmother, Lewis and Diane, his brother Logan, and his grandparents, Ernest and Alice, number 26, Tanner Luna. He's a right-hand pitcher from Hempstead, Weston Smart. Weston has made 32 appearances in his two seasons at HBU, posting a 5.79 ERA, 27 strikeouts. This season he has made 21 appearances, with a 4.66 ERA and 14 strikeouts in 29 innings. In yesterday's win over Stephen F. Austin, Weston threw 4.1 strong innings of relief. Last year, he picked up his first win at HBU, allowing one run on six hits in four innings of relief in a 3-2 victory over 25th-ranked Houston on February 21st, 2017. Escorted by his parents, Rusty and Carol, and his fiancée, Laura Mullins, number 8, Weston Smart. He's a second baseman from Mason City, Iowa, Jack Fitzgerald. Jack has played in 86 games with 76 starts in his two seasons at HBU, totaling four doubles, a triple, four home runs, 25 RBIs, and 29 runs. This season he has three home runs, driven in 15, and scored 17. In a win over Texas Southern on February 20th, Jack hit two home runs, one inside the park, and recorded eight RBIs. In the 2017 Southland Conference Tournament, he went 2-for-4 with a double, an RBI, and scored twice in a win over Lamar, and 3-for-3 with a double, an RBI, and two runs in a win that eliminated top-seeded McNeese. Escorted by his parents, John and Shelley, number 10, Jack Fitzgerald. Is a first baseman from Cypress, Kerry Jones. Kerry is a four-year member of the HBU baseball team, playing in 115 games and totaling six home runs, 15 doubles, 22 RBIs, and 22 runs. This year he started 13 games, homering in a win over Southeastern Louisiana and driving in two in a win against Lamar. Last season, Jones hit a career high, three home runs, and went 2-for-4 with a double and a run in a 3-2 win over 25th-ranked Houston. As a sophomore, he went 4-for-7 with two doubles, a home run, and four RBIs at Prairie View A&M, and delivered a game-tying RBI double in the ninth inning of an eventual 3-2 extra-inning victory at Central Arkansas on March 26, 2016. Escorted by his parents, Mike and Donna, his brother Curtis, and his girlfriend Danielle Raveling, number 38, Carrie Jones. Is a first baseman and catcher from Menifee, California, Jake Pulshan. Jake has played in 104 games with 101 starts in his two seasons at HBU, totaling 6 home runs, 12 doubles, 2 triples, 65 RBIs, and 42 runs. This year he has 3 home runs, 4 doubles, a triple, 28 RBIs, and 19 runs. He homered in a win over Sam Houston State last Friday, homered in back-to-back games at Abilene Christian, and delivered a walk-off single in Thursday's win over Stephen F. Austin. Last season, Jake went 6-for-10 with 6 RBIs in the series sweep of Sam Houston State and went 2-for-4 with 2 RBIs in the Southland Conference Tournament win over top-seeded McNeese. Escorted by his mother Lisa and his sister Jody, number 40, Jake Pulshan. He is a shortstop from Rancho Santa Maria, California, Tyler the Preta Johnson. Tyler has started all 107 games in his two seasons at HBU, hitting .281 with 6 home runs, 16 doubles, a triple, 50 RBIs, and 62 runs. This season he has 4 home runs, 10 doubles, 27 RBIs, and 27 runs, and is the only shortstop in the nation with one error or fewer with at least 200 chances. Last year, Tyler was the shortstop on the Southland Conference All-Defensive Team and earned second-team All-Conference honors. He hit .309 with 2 home runs, a triple, 6 doubles, 23 RBIs, and 34 runs. At the Southland Conference Tournament, he homered in a win over top-seeded McNeese and went 3-for-4 with a pair of runs in a win over Central Arkansas to send the Huskies to the championship on Saturday. Escorted by his parents, Josh Johnson and Diane DePreta, number 3, Tyler DePreta Johnson.
It's not in there yet.
Okay.
Yeah, you're good. Go ahead.
He's an outfielder and pitcher from Midlothian, Matt Heck. Matt has played in 88 games in his two seasons at HBU, hitting .308 with 10 home runs, 16 doubles, 7 triples, 56 RBIs, and 42 runs. This season he is hitting .362 with 9 home runs, 10 doubles, 5 triples, 45 RBIs, and 31 runs overall, and is hitting .405 with a league-leading 7 home runs and 34 RBIs in the Southland Conference play. He is also 4-1 with a save, 5.09 ERA, 12 strikeouts, and 16 appearances on the mound. In the series finale against Nichols on March 17th, Matt recorded the final out in the ninth, then blasted a 2-run walk-off home run to earn the win. He's also hit a 2-run home run and tossed 2 scoreless innings for the save in a 3-1 win over Houston on March 6th and went 4-for-7 with a double, a home run, and 6 RBIs in a win over Abilene Christian on April 13th. Matt had a stretch where he hit safely in 20 of 21 games and was voted the Southland Conference Hitter of the Week on April 23rd. Escorted by his parents, Rick and Lisa, number 5, Matt Heck. Did I screw something up?
No, okay. Keep going.
That last one. Yeah. Finally, he's an outfielder and third baseman from Sheffield, Iowa, Spencer Halloran. He started all 107 games in his two seasons at HBU, hitting .330 with 12 home runs, 29 doubles, 5 triples, 71 RBIs, 83 runs, and 29 stolen bases. This season, he is hitting .332 with 9 home runs, 17 doubles, a triple, 39 RBIs, 41 runs, and 18 stolen bases, and is tied for the league lead with 7 homers in conference play. Spencer leads the team with 22 multi-hit games this year, including 6 three-hit games, a 4-hit effort, and a 5-hit performance. Halloran homered 3 times in the series against Nichols, driving in 5 runs in the finale, and went 5-for-5 with 2 doubles, 2 home runs, 6 RBIs, and scored 4 times in a win over Abilene Christian on April 13th. He was named the Southland Conference Hitter of the Week on April 2nd. Last year, he was selected to the Southland Conference All-Tournament Team, going for 5-for-5 in a win over Lamar, capping a season in which he hit .329 with 3 home runs, 12 doubles, 4 triples, 32 RBIs, and 42 runs. Escorted by his parents, Mark and Amy Simons, number 14, Spencer Halloran.
Yeah,
Ladies and gentlemen, your 2018 senior class, let's hear it one more time for the 14 members.
Goodness.
It was just marathon.
Thanks.
It's time for HBU Huskies Baseball. This is HBU Huskies Baseball on your home for Houston Baptist University Athletics, the Husky Sports Network. The Husky Sports Network is powered by the Legacy Sports Network. And HBU Baseball is brought to you by these corporate partners of HBU Athletics: Houston Federal Credit Union, the Memorial Hermann Healthcare System, Pepsi, IBEW Local 716, Firehouse Subs, Kolache Factory, HUB International, and DoubleTree Suites Hotels. Now it's just about time for the first pitch, but let's go out to the ballpark and get ready for HBU Huskies Baseball.
And welcome to the HBU Baseball pregame show. I'm Russ Reneau. You're watching the Huskies Sports Network. Thanks for joining us here on HBUHuskies.com. The regular season finale, Southland Conference finale, between the HBU Huskies and the Stephen F. Austin Lumberjacks. Huskies have won the first two games of this series, a 10-9 10th inning walk-off victory in Thursday's game, and then an 8-3 victory yesterday. Huskies looking for the sweep today. There's still a lot at stake. The only thing we know about next week's Southland Conference tournament is that Sam Houston State is the number one seed and Southeastern Louisiana is the two seed. The Huskies can finish 3, 4, or 5. And there are four teams battling for the last two spots in the tournament, and we'll see how that shakes out over the course of the afternoon. We'll check in on the Southland Conference scoreboard as it goes along, and then probably won't know until after the game. So check HBUHuskies.com to find out exactly where the Huskies end up in these standings. There'll be a pair of right-handers going today in this season finale, Trevor Kaminsky for the Lumberjacks and Brady Batten for the Huskies. When we come back on the HBU Baseball pregame show, we'll get you the starting lineups, take a look around the Southland Conference, get through the scores from last night, go through those jumbled up standings, and then we're on to the first pitch. You're listening to Huskies Baseball on the Husky Sports Network.
Are you a graduate of Houston Baptist University? Did you know the value of your degree increases when you actively participate in the HBU Alumni Association? Your Alumni Association actively supports the growth, retention, and ranking of our school by our scholarship efforts. Husky Alumni Network volunteers actively work to recruit the best and brightest to HBU, and we promote and support programs intended to build a growing network of people committed to quality, higher Christian education through our alumni scholarship efforts. We also work to strengthen the bond between our university and the community, and we're your connection to over 18,000 fellow alumni, mostly in and around the Houston metro area. Log on to learn more about our mission and your privileges and benefits at hbu.edu/alumni and find us via social media on Facebook at the Houston Baptist University Alumni Association page and on Twitter and Instagram at @HBU_alumni. But no matter how you do it, connect with the HBU Alumni Association because a strong alumni base equals a strong HBU.
Back on the HB Baseball pregame show. Time now to get to the starting lineups. First for visiting Stephen F. Austin, 17-35 overall, 9-20 in the Southland Conference under head coach Johnny Cardenas. Leading off playing center field is Nick Miner. Batting second, playing third base, Jake Georgiadis. Batting third in left field, Jared Martin. Batting cleanup, the first baseman, Josh Evans. Batting fifth, the DH, Skylar Black. Batting sixth, that second base is Eric DeJesus. Batting seventh, the shortstop, Manny Vasquez. Batting eighth and catching is Jared Huber. And batting ninth in right field is Josh Campbell. On the mound today for the Lumberjacks is senior right-hander Trevor Kaminsky. And for the HBU Huskies, 25-28 overall, 17-12 in the Southland under head coach Jared Moon. Leading off, playing shortstop, Tyler DePreta Johnson. Batting second in center field is Jonathan Dukoff. Batting third and playing left field, Spencer Halloran. Batting cleanup, the DH, Matt Heck. Batting fifth and catching, Jake Fulshawn. Batting sixth in right field is Anthony Jones. Batting seventh, the third baseman, Elijah Simone. Batting eighth at first base is Kerry Jones. Batting ninth and playing second base is Jack Fitzgerald. On the mound for the Huskies, junior right-hander Brady Batten. Now let's look at the Southland Conference standings. Heading into today, as we said, Sam Houston State's wrapped up the regular season title, 23-6 in the league. Southeastern Louisiana, 21-9. Northwestern State is 17-11. Central Arkansas and HBU each 17-12. Those three teams virtually tied for third, and we'll see how those shake out. The Huskies can finish third, fourth, or fifth. All three of those teams could. McNeese is locked into the sixth seed at 15-14, New Orleans 13-15, Incarnate Word 13-16, Texas A&M Corpus Christi 13-16, and Nichols 13-16. Those four teams playing for the final two spots in the Southland Conference tournament. Lamar is 12-17, Stephen F. Austin 9-20, and Abilene Christian is 5-24. So we look at the scores from last night's action. Texas A&M Corpus Christi defeated Abilene Christian 9-2. Sam Houston State over Incarnate Word 16-1. McNeese fell to Lamar 6-2. Nichols over Central Arkansas 4-0. And Southeastern Louisiana out of conference this weekend defeated number 22 Houston 5-4. Northwestern State is at New Orleans. They were postponed last night. They play a doubleheader today, and that will affect a lot of things as we head into the Southland Conference Tournament. Well, we're just about ready for the first pitch. We'll take a break for the national anthem. Then we'll come back with all the action here on the Husky Sports Network.
We know travel isn't what it used to be. By the time you get where you're going, you've been through it all. So what if you knew there was a hotel that understands how hard your journey's been and spends all its time making up for it? At DoubleTree by Hilton, with more than 325 wonderful destinations around the world, we welcome our guests with a warm chocolate chip cookie. Our cookie serves as a symbol of our commitment to turn every little detail of your stay into a delight. Preparing every comfort with care, making every touch special, and every gesture true. Giving that extra attention to the simple things. Bringing humanity back to business and leisure travel. So you can reconnect, relax, play, focus, smile. Welcome to DoubleTree by Hilton. Where the little things mean everything.
The real story is I'm in here every morning and sample just about every kolache that they make here.
Bacon, egg, and cheese on wheat for me, and then the rest is for the office. So yes, I'll pick up every Friday. I'll stop by here and pick up some for my group. So.
Well, I used to think it was just fruit-filled stuff, and then I came here and there's eggs and bacon and cheese and all kinds of good stuff in there. It's like a whole breakfast in a bun. It's great.
It's always a good thing if you can eat healthy and not know it.
When you drive down the street looking for something to eat, you're going to pass five places to buy a sandwich, six places to buy a burger. There's only one place you can get a kolache, and that's Kolache Factory. It's delicious. You're going to have people that try to copy you, but they're not going to do it as well. We know what we're doing. We've been doing it for 25 years. We do it the best, and our success proves that.
Houston's own Kolache Factory, the freshest, highest quality, best tasting kolaches in town. Over 50 Houston area locations and a proud partner of HBU Athletics.
Tammy and I have been going steady since high school.
Tammy and Tommy, two peas in a pod, as they say.
We have all the same friends. We like all the same things. I mean, we practically even have the same name.
But there's one thing we could just never agree on.
Soda.
I have been begging him all these years to just try Pepsi, and I knew he would change his tune.
Yeah, yeah.
So, finally, I had him take the Pepsi Taste Challenge. And go on, tell him what you told me, Tommy.
I'm a Pepsi man. Mmm.
Right? Gosh, isn't Pepsi so good?
I tell you what, I don't know why I didn't try it sooner.
Me neither.
It's so crisp and refreshing and bubbly.
Like me.
Like you.
I'm always right.
She's always right.
All across the South, people are choosing the great taste of Pepsi. Take the Pepsi Taste Challenge and let your taste decide.
At Houston Federal Credit Union, we're dedicated to our members, our communities, and now the students, faculty, and employees of Houston Baptist University. From checking and savings accounts to loans, IRAs, money markets, and other financial tools, HFCU is ready to serve the HBU Huskies and their fans. Learn more today. Call 866-OUR-HFCU or log on to HoustonFCU.org. Houston Federal Credit Union and the HBU Huskies. That's a doggone good team.
Houston Federal Credit Union is federally insured by NCUA.
And welcome to the regular season and Southland Conference finale between HBU Huskies and the Stephen F. Austin Lumberjacks. I'm Russ Renaud. You're watching the Husky Sports Network on HBUHuskies.com. That's junior right-hander Brady Batten on the mound today for HBU. Brady, 6 foot, 195 pounds, from Bryan, Texas, and Rutter High School. Making his 15th appearance, his 13th start, 3-6 with a 3.66 ERA. He's given up 35 runs, 32 of them earned on 71 hits, 62 strikeouts, and 33 walks in 78 and two-thirds innings. top of the order for Stephen F. Austin. It's Nick Miner, Jake Georgiadis, and Jared Martin. Miner, junior center fielder from Flower Mound, Texas.
Number two, Nick Miner.
Nick hitting 291 with nine doubles, a triple, a home run, 26 RBIs, and 25 runs scored. Miner went 1-for-3 and scored a run yesterday. 3-for-5 with a run scored in Thursday's opener. Batting with the first pitch of the game, and it's a strike. We are underway here in Houston. Slider for strike two. Umpiring crew for today, Terry Harrison behind the plate, Bob Charmo at first, and Bill Powell at third base. Batten winds and delivers. Fastball high, 1-2. One-two pitch and a breaking ball. That was a beautiful pitch. Called a ball to even the count. The 2-2, up and in, and the count goes full. Breaking ball, and it hits Miner. Throws the bat all the way into the dugout. So leadoff base runner for the Lumberjacks.
Number 26, Jake Georgiadis.
That'll be junior third baseman Jake Georgiadis. It's from College Station, Texas. Hitting 340, seven doubles, a home run, 22 RBIs, 25 runs scored. Went 4-for-5 with a double and drove in four runs in Thursday's opener. 1-for-2 with an RBI yesterday. Takes ball one outside. Beautiful day here in Houston. Fastball in there for strike one, 1-1. 90 degrees of game time. Partly cloudy sky. Winds out of the south-southeast at 16 miles per hour, so blowing out pretty hard to left. Throw over, and Miner is picked off. Dancing around over there trying to get Batten's attention, and he did. He's picked off with the first out. Now batting from the windup again, the 1-1. A breaking ball that misses high. Lower strike zone today for Terry Harrison. That looked right across the midsection. 2-1 pitch. And a fastball in the outside corner, and the count goes to 2-2. Batting working quickly, and a breaking ball fouled away. Dimensions here at Husky Field, 330 down the lines, 380 in the gaps, 405 to straightaway center. Biggest ballpark by dimension in the Southland Conference. 2-2 pitch, fastball. Man, that looked like a good pitch. So it's in the strike zone's not low or high. Now it's 3-2. Fouled away. Georgiadis stays alive. Batting with a payoff pitch, and there's strike three at the knees on the inside corner. Two down and nobody on.
Left fielder number 33,
Jared Martin, a freshman left fielder from Frisco, Texas and Wakeland High School. He's hitting 278 with 18 doubles, a triple, 5 home runs, 32 driven in, and 38 runs scored. Takes the ball down low. Martin 1-for-4 with a walk in Thursday's opener. 1-for-3 yesterday. It's a strike on the outer edge. The slider low and away, 2-1. The defense for the Huskies, Kerry Jones at first, Jack Fitzgerald at second, Tyler DePreta Johnson at shortstop, Elijah Simone at third, Spencer Halloran in left, Jonathan Dukoff in center, and Anthony Jones in right. Jake Pulshon doing the catching. Fastball low, and it's 3-1. Chop foul, and the count goes full. Payoff pitch on the way and a line drive. Base hit into left for Martin. That'll bring up senior first baseman Josh Evans.
First baseman
from Ponca City, Oklahoma.
Josh Evans.
Hitting 292, 13 doubles, 8 home runs, 38 RBIs, 30 runs scored. Evans 0-for-6 on Thursday. Didn't see him in yesterday's game. Well, yes, he did pinch hit in yesterday's game. Went 0-for-1. Takes ball 1 down low. Huskies white pants with the blue pinstripes today and the thicker orange and blue stripe down the sides. Orange tops with the blue HBU logo on the chest. The blue cap and the orange bill. 2-0 now to Evans. Martin on first. Lumberjacks, white pants with the pinstripes, black tops. Jackson script across the front in purple. The black cap of the purple bill today. 3-0 on Evans. Slider in there for strike 1. Chopper up the third baseline. Simone has it. The throw over to first in time for the third out. We go to the bottom of the first. SFA nothing. HBU coming to bat here on the Husky Sports Network.
Well, how about it?
Recording artist Kevin Fowler.
Oh, I love the sound of fast boats racing, rooster tails are flying high. Love to hear all my riding friends rocking, howling at the full moonlight. Love to see those fireflies buzzing, lighting up the southern sky. Yeah, I'm a hellbent 100% Texan till I die. Like lots of 100% Texans, I love having a good time on the water. But remember, nobody's waterproof. Play it safe. Wear a life jacket and designate a driver for the boat and for a safe ride home. Follow these tips and there'll be a lot more days for you to play in this great state of Texas. Nobody's waterproof, yeah, that's a helmet truth, and you know it ain't no lie.
Sponsored by Texas Parks and Wildlife.
Bottom of the first inning here at Husky Field. On the mound today for Stephen F. Austin is senior right-hander Trevor Kaminsky. 6'3", 217 pounds from Brooklyn Park, Minnesota. Kaminsky making his 14th start. He's 2-5.
Number three, Tyler,
5.31 ERA. He's given up 41 runs, 35 of them earned on 50 hits, 30 strikeouts, 32 walks, and 59 and one-third innings. It'll be Tyler DePreta Johnson deleted off here for HBU. Tyler, senior shortstop from Rancho Santa Margarita, California, takes ball one high. Tyler hitting 254, 10 doubles, 4 home runs, 27 driven in, 28 scored. The strike on the outside corner, it's 1-1. Yesterday, Tyler a 1-for-4 with a double, an RBI, and a run scored. 0-for-4 and scored a run, drew a walk in Thursday's opener. Fastball back to the screen, and it's 2-1. Two-one pitch. Looked pretty low. Catcher caught it right at DePreta Johnson's foot. It's called a strike, and it's 2-2. And that one is low for ball three. Three-two pitch. Foul ball to the right side. Another 3-2 and another foul ball away. Kaminsky delivers. Up and in for ball four.
Center fielder number 27, Jonathan Dukoff.
And that'll be junior center fielder Jonathan Dukoff in Kingwood, Kingwood Park High School, hitting 272. 12 doubles, 7 home runs, 20 RBIs, 24 runs scored. Yesterday, Jonathan 2-for-5. With a double, 3 RBIs, and a run score. 0-for-4 and drove in a run in Thursday's opener and takes ball one low. So today is senior day. Huskies honoring 14 members of this 2018 squad. Jonathan Dukoff included in that. He's a senior academically. He walked across the stage, received his diploma last Saturday. Everybody in the lineup, very senior heavy today, except for Anthony Jones and Elijah Simone. DePreta Johnson dancing off first, but Kaminsky didn't see him. It's the way Nick Miner got picked off in the first inning. Everybody else in the lineup today, seniors. This one driven to left, and that sends Martin back, and that is in the gap and off the base of the wall. It's going to kick back in towards the infield. DePreta Johnson's going to score easily, and Dukoff gives the Huskies the lead with a stand-up double.
Left fielder number 14, Spencer Howlett.
13th double of the season for Dukoff. 21 RBIs now. That brings up senior left fielder Spencer Halloran. He's from Sheffield, Iowa. hitting 332 with 17 doubles, a triple, 9 home runs, 39 RBIs, 41 runs scored. Low and away for ball one. The opener Thursday, Spencer went 4 for 5 with 2 doubles, 2 RBIs and 3 runs scored. 1 for 5 with a run scored yesterday. That one hit was a double. Fastball called a strike. Looked pretty low. A 1-1 pitch. Fouled back. 1-2 on Halloran. There's a line drive, but it's right at DeJesus, the second baseman, for the first out. Here's the defense for the Lumberjacks. Black at first base, DeJesus at second, Vasquez at short. Georgiades at third, Martin in left, Miner in center, and Campbell in right field. Huber doing the catching. Here is senior designated hitter Matt Heck. He's from Midlothian, Texas. Runner goes, and it's fouled away. It's 0-1. Heck hitting 362. 10 doubles, 5 triples, 9 home runs, 45 RBIs, 31 run score. In Southland Conference play, Matt hitting 405 now. 7 bombs. He's driven in 34. So vying for that triple crown in conference play today. Tied for the league lead in homers, leading in RBIs. Should be a comfortable lead in that category. The pitch is outside, and it's 1-1. Does have a pretty good race going with Texas A&M Corpus Christi's Itchy Burts, though, for the league lead in batting average. Don't know what Itchy's numbers did to his average yesterday. He came in hitting 410 yesterday, and now Heck at 405. Dukoff at second, 1-1 count on Heck. One out, bottom of the first inning. Huskies leading 1-0. Ripped foul. So it's 1-2 on Heck. Kaminsky comes set. Checks Dukoff at second. Pitches inside, and that'll even the count. Two-two pitch, low and away, and the count goes full. A lot of full counts here early for both pitchers. The 3-2, and that is up high for ball four. Brings up senior catcher Jake Pulshan from Menifee, California. Catcher, California Military Jake Institute. Pulshan. Getting 237. 4 doubles, a triple, 3 home runs, 28 RBIs, 20 runs scored. Yesterday, Jake went 3-for-5 with a triple. Scored a run. 1-for-4, 2 RBIs, and a run scored in Thursday's opener. Had the walk-off single in the 10th inning in that game. A 10-9 victory for HBU. 8-3 win yesterday. First pitch is up high for ball one. Two on and one out. That is low and in. 2 balls and no strikes to Jake. Spin and a fake towards second. Dukoff getting a pretty good lead over there at second. Two oh pitch is high. Throw down to first. Three and oh on Pulshawn. Dukoff at second, Heck at first. Kaminsky delivers. A strike. Three-one pitch. That is down low for ball four. That'll load the bases with one out for Anthony Jones, junior right fielder from Missouri City, Texas, and Ridge Point High School. Hitting 276 with 5 doubles, 2 home runs, 12 RBIs, 23 runs scored. We've got a visit out to the mound to Kaminsky, who has loaded the bases with one out here in the first. Huskies already leading 1-0. The RBI double by Jonathan Dukoff. Anthony Jones coming to the plate yesterday. Went 0-for-3. 1-for-4 with an RBI on Thursday. It's up here with the bases loaded. Corner infielders are in. Georgiadis at third and Black at first. Anthony with a chopper to the left side. Georgiadis to second for one, over to first, and it's not in time. Jones beats it out, and the Huskies now lead it 2-0 on the fielder's choice.
Third baseman number 36, Elijah Simone.
The runners on the corners and two down for Elijah Simone, sophomore third baseman from Angleton, Texas. Brazosport Christian High School hitting 267. 2 doubles, 2 triples, 4 home runs, 11 driven in, 27 runs scored. Yesterday, Eli 1-for-3 with 2 RBIs and a run scored. Thursday went 1-for-2, walked 3 times and scored 3 times, and Anthony Jones on the move. And he's into second base with a stolen base. And strike one to Eli. Anthony with his 9th stolen base of the year. And this pitch driven into right center field, and that's down, and that is by the right fielder for a base hit. Simone heading for second, and he is in there with a 2-run double, and the Huskies lead it 4-0.
First baseman number 38, Kerry Jones.
So it's senior first baseman Kerry Jones. He's from Cypress, Texas, Cy Ranch High School. Hitting 138 with four doubles, a home run, five RBIs, six runs scored. Fastball low and away, 1-0. That is Simone's third double of the year, 13 RBIs now. Two and oh. Action in the Lumberjacks bullpen. A right-hander getting loosened up. That one's low and away, 3-0 to Jones. Pitch. A strike by Kaminsky. Pitch. Popped up on the infield. Georgiadis under it. Makes the catch for the third out. The Huskies score four. Here in the bottom of the first, lead at 4-0. Just go to the second here on the Husky Sports Network.
Hey fans, today's second inning is sponsored by...
Let Houston Federal Credit Union be there for all the stages of your life. Take advantage of our products and services to help you with all your financial milestones, such as purchasing a car, buying a home, and planning for retirement. We're the credit union that will always have your back and helps you save money along the way. Houston Federal Credit Union is the official credit union of HBU. Experience the credit union difference today. Stop by any of our convenient locations or visit our website, HoustonFCU.org.
Of electric workers, Local 716 in Houston, get up for work each day because we believe building schools to code matters. Because building Houston's hospitals correctly saves lives. Because training for 10,000 hours makes a difference. That's why we get up, because we want to make a difference. To be the best, hire the best.
IBEW, where skill and value lock arms. The time is now to hire IBEW electricians.
Leading off the second for the Lumberjacks, the designated hitter, number 30, Skyler Black.
Leading it off for SFA here in the top of the second is sophomore designated hitter, Skyler Black. Pitch is in there for strike one. Black hitting 266, nine doubles, a triple, four home runs, 20 RBIs, and 17 runs scored, and he takes strike two. Breaking ball swung on and missed. Black is the first strikeout victim by Batten. Make that the second. Georgiadis struck out as well, and there's one down here in the second.
Second baseman, number three, Eric DeJesus.
DeJesus swings at the first pitch and a pop-up into left. Halloran under it makes a catch. Brown, number two. DeJesus, the senior second baseman. He's from Dyball, Texas, and he came in hitting 280 with five doubles, a triple, three home runs, and 26 driven in, 24 runs scored. Gives way to junior shortstop Manny Vasquez from Naco, Arizona. Hitting 278, nine doubles, five home runs, 23 RBIs, and 27 runs scored. Fastball away, and it's 1-0. Popped up. There's room for Pulshan, but he doesn't see it. Couldn't find it. might have been a play that he could have made. Landed about 15 feet behind him. He had no idea where it was. Those ones that go straight back that are the issue sometimes. A 1-1 pitch and a bouncing ball up the middle. And a base hit for Vasquez.
Catcher number 23, Jared Hoover.
That'll be junior catcher Jared Hoover. Hitting 284, 8 doubles, triple, 2 home runs, 15 driven in, 21 runs scored. It's up here with a runner on and 2 down. Ground ball to second. Fitzgerald has it. Goes over to first for the third out. Go to the bottom of the second. HBU 4, SFA nothing. Here on the Husky Sports Network.
All right.
A firefighter's duty. Fighting fires, rescuing citizens, performing copious kettlebell exercises demands a daring degree of readiness. A degree of readiness achieved eating fulfillingly flavorful firehouse subs. With premium carved meats and cheeses steamed to tasty magnificence then piled onto toasted rolls. Is your footwear connected to your pants? No, it's not. Because you're not a firefighter. But you can be ready like one. Firehouse subs, the hero of all subs.
At Raising Cane's, we know lots of people want the recipe for our delicious cane sauce. But we'll take the secret to our Graves. You know, our founder, Todd Graves. He's the guy who figured out which blend of spices makes every drop of sauce totally tasty. Of course, it helps that our cane sauce is made fresh every single day, no matter what. And Todd's also the guy who won't spill a secret recipe. But you can dip in it all you like. Raising Cane's, one love.
Russ Renault welcoming you in on this beautiful Saturday afternoon.
Number 10, Jack Fitzgerald.
The final day of the regular season in Southland Conference play. HBU leading Stephen F. Austin 4-0. Nearly batted around in the first inning, so it'll be number 9 hitter Jack Fitzgerald to lead it off. Senior second baseman from Mason City, Iowa, Newman Catholic High School. Jack hitting 220 with a double, a triple, 3 home runs, 15 driven in, 17 runs scored. Kaminsky misses high for ball one. Kaminsky threw 33 pitches in that first inning. Walked 3 batters, gave up 2 hits. Chopper towards third, Georgiadis back on it. Long throw over to first just in time to get Fitzgerald.
Shortstop number 3, Tyler DePreda Johnson.
I said in the first thing it was Black at first. It's actually Evans. Black started yesterday's game at first base. Evans was there on Thursday. So now it's Evans back there. Tyler DePreda Johnson fouls off the first pitch. Drew a walk and scored. The first run of the game for the Huskies, scored on the RBI double by Jonathan Dukal. Huskies added 3 more after that. The 0-1 pitch outside for ball one. Foul ball, and it's 1-2. I don't think anybody will mind if I keep a closer look on the Southland Conference scoreboard today. May go through that a little more often than usual. 1-2 pitch, ground ball, and a diving stop by Vasquez. The throw to first is not in time. Great play by the Lumberjack shortstop, but DePreda Johnson beats it out for an infield single. With that walk in the first inning,
number 27, Jonathan
Tyler reaching in his 10th straight game and getting on via the hit this time. He had that 7-game hitting streak ended on Thursday, but he did walk in that game. So he's hit safely in 9 out of his last 10. He's reached in all 10. Here's Jonathan Dukoff, the double off the wall in the first inning, and he takes strike one. RBI double, number 13, second on the team behind Spencer Halloran, who has 17. Throw over to first. DePreta Johnson, not a big threat to steal. He's 4 for 12, and most of that has been on failed hit and runs that he's been caught. Dukoff fouls that one away, behind in the count 0-2. Throw over to first. Games Huskies most interested in: Northwestern State at New Orleans, playing a doubleheader today. They were washed out last night, and then Central Arkansas at Nichols. The 0-2 pitch is up high. So New Orleans leading Northwestern State 4-0 in the bottom of the fifth inning. First game of that doubleheader. And then Central Arkansas Nichols just underway. No score, top of the second in Thibodeau. Huskies would be the 3 seed outright if Northwestern. And there's a chopper towards second. DeJesus goes to second for one. And over to first for the double play. DeJesus took it himself. That'll end the inning. We go to the third, HBU 4. SFA nothing here on the Husky Sports Network.
At the Memorial Hermann Ironman Sports Medicine Institute, we're dedicated to the dedicated, who lace up before sunrise, who don't let a hard hit keep them down, who want the ball when the game's on the line. So team up with the Memorial Hermann Ironman Sports Medicine Institute at Texas Medical Center, Memorial City, or The Woodlands, where our affiliated surgeons, specialists, and physical therapists offer all athletes the elite care they need to forge ahead.
Daddy, where do babies come from?
Honey?
Mommy went to the store.
Oh, well, you see, there's a mommy and a daddy, right?
Right.
And see, when they call Geico, they could save a bunch of money on car insurance.
Oh, really? And that makes them happy?
Yes, that makes them very happy.
That's good.
Yeah. Well, I'm glad we could have this talk, Sunshine.
Geico, because saving 15% or more on car insurance is always a great answer.
Nine, one, and two, due up for the Lumberjacks here in the third. Sophomore right fielder Josh Campbell to lead it off.
Josh Campbell.
He's from Angleton, Texas, and Angleton High School. Hitting 310, 4 doubles, 3 home runs, 22 RBIs, 19 runs scored. Yesterday, Josh went 1-for-4, takes strike one. On Thursday, did a lot of damage, 4-for-5. With a double, 3 RBIs, and 2 runs scored. And that fastball's in there for strike two. So we were going through the Southland Conference scoreboard earlier. Ball one away. As I was saying, Central Arkansas loses today, and Northwestern State get swept in that doubleheader at New Orleans, the Huskies would be the 3 seed outright. Ball up and away, 2-2. Central Arkansas wins, and Northwestern State splits that doubleheader. There'll be a three-way tie for third place, and we'll have to sort that out later on today. There's a foul ball ripped down the left field line. Texas A&M Corpus Christi leading Abilene Christian 6-2, top of the fifth inning in Abilene. Islanders have gotten a little bit of a hot streak and played themselves into contention for one of those final two spots in the tournament next week. 2-2 pitch and a breaking ball off the fist and into left field for a base hit. Back to the top of the order, Nick Miner. He was hit by a pitch to lead off the game but was picked off. So Sam Houston State is at Incarnate Word. Bearcats leading 1-0, top of the third inning. Bearcats have wrapped up the regular season title. UIW has hit the skids and in danger of missing the tournament now, falling into that virtual four-way tie heading into today. Here's a strike. It's 0-1. Later on today, McNeese is at Lamar. That'll get underway in about 15 minutes. And then the second game of the doubleheader between Northwestern State and New Orleans will be after the first one. Be a lot at stake for everybody in that last game. There's a strike down the middle. 0-2 to Miner. Because you've got Northwestern State, who's virtually tied with Central Arkansas and HBU. And New Orleans virtually tied with everybody for the last two spots. That would determine 7 and 8. So 7, 8, 9, 10. That'll determine that order of finish. The 0-2 pitch and a breaking ball high. So everybody will be watching or keeping an eye on Northwestern State at New Orleans later on this afternoon. So the Huskies probably won't know their seeding until that game finishes up today. Nobody will. Except for Sam and Southeastern. Pitch is fouled off. It's 1-2. So the only thing we know, Sam Houston State is 1, Southeastern Louisiana is 2, and McNeese is 6. That has everything that is all locked up right now. Another 1-2 pitch from Batten. Slashed foul. Nick Miner wears those big work gloves. Instead of the batting gloves. Another throw over to first. Southland Conference Tournament gets underway on Wednesday. 1-2 pitch. Chopper to second. Fitzgerald charging in. Flips it to DePreta Johnson for one. Over to first for the double play. Such quick hands by Tyler DePreta Johnson. That is why he is one of the best defensive shortstops in the country.
Third baseman number 26, Jake Georgiadis.
That'll bring up Jake Georgiadis. Two outs and nobody on now. Struck out looking his first time up. Drives this one into center. Dukoff is there, makes the catch for the third out. We go to the bottom of the third, HBU 4, SFA nothing, here on the Husky Sports Network.
Coming to you in Living Cola.
The joy of cola.
Pepsi Cola, from the wonderful folks who put the R in cola.
Spencer Halloran to lead it off for the Huskies here in the bottom of the third inning against Trevor Kaminsky. Spencer lined out to second, his first time up back in the first inning. Huskies leading at 4-0 as they scored four runs in the bottom of the first. On the outside corner, called strike one. Swing and a miss on the slider. Kaminsky ahead in the count, 0-2. Kaminsky with the pitch and a fastball high. One-two pitch. Fly ball down the right field line. Campbell and Evans giving chase. Campbell makes the catch for the first out. Brings up Matt Heck. Mac walked and scored back in the first inning. Swings at the first pitch and fouls it back. The 0-1 pitch, low and away for ball one. Low and away, two balls and one strike. That ball swung on and missed, 2-2. Kaminsky at 51 pitches, 28 for strikes. Fastball away and the count goes full. Payoff pitch to Heck. The chopper towards third. Georgiadis bobbles it for a second. Makes a low throw, but Evans able to come up with it for a second out.
Number 40, Jake Pulshon.
Here's Jake Pulshon. Takes pitch inside for ball one. Jake walked in the first inning. chopper foul. One pitch, low and away. Pretty good crowd here at Husky Field on this final Saturday. Senior day bringing out a lot of the families. 2-1. Bullshawn takes it low for ball three. And Stephen F. Austin not being too far away, drawing a crowd as well this weekend. Three-one pitch. That is away for ball four. Pulshawn draws another walk.
Right fielder number one, Anthony Jones.
There's a game earlier this season where Jake Pulshawn, I believe it was against UT Rio Grande Valley. It was a Tuesday afternoon. Jake drew a walk in each of the first four innings. Here's Anthony Jones. Reached on a fielder's choice, drove in a run in the first inning, wound up scoring. The strike call. Chopper to the left side, picked by Vasquez, a shortstop, and a nice play for the third out. Got the fourth inning, HBU 4, SFA nothing here on the Husky Sports Network.
Are you a graduate of Houston Baptist University? Did you know the value of your degree increases when you actively participate in the HBU Alumni Association? Your Alumni Association actively supports the growth, retention, and ranking of our school by our scholarship efforts. Husky Alumni Network volunteers actively work to recruit the best and brightest to HBU, and we promote and support programs intended to build a growing network of people committed to quality, higher Christian education through our alumni scholarship efforts. We also work to strengthen the bond between our university and the community, and we're your connection to over 18,000 fellow alumni, mostly in and around the Houston metro area. Log on to learn more about our mission and your privileges and benefits at hbu.edu/alumni. And find us via social media on Facebook at the Houston Baptist University Alumni Association page and on Twitter and Instagram at @HBU_alumni. But no matter how you do it, connect with the HBU Alumni Association because a strong alumni base equals a strong HBU.
Go to the top of the fourth inning here at Husky Field in Houston.
Leading off the fourth for the Lumberjacks.
The short Jared Martin.
13, Manny Vasquez.
Jared Martin at the plate. Takes ball one inside. Martin singled his first time up back in the first inning. Popped up and fouled back, one and one. So 3, 4, and 5 due up for the Lumberjacks. A line drive the other way down the right field line and into the corner for extra bases. Anthony Jones gets over to it, but Martin heading for third, and he's going to be in there easily with a triple. Jared Martin with his second triple of the year. to lead it off here in the top of the fourth.
First baseman, number 17, Josh Evans.
That'll be Josh Evans. Grounded out to third to end the first inning, his first time up. Fourth hit of the game for the Lumberjacks. The fastball from Batten misses high. Up and in, 2-0 now to Evans. 50 pitches for Batten, 31 have been for strikes. 2-0 pitch, slider gets away from him, 3-0. Is down low. A four-pitch walk to Evans. Runners on the corners with nobody out for Skyler Black.
Designated hitter number 30, Skyler Black.
Inside for ball one. Up high for ball two. Jake Pulshon going out to talk to Batten, and he'll be joined by pitching coach Xavier Hernandez. Huskies leading 4-0, top of the fourth inning. But the Lumberjacks now with runners on the corners and nobody out. Der Martin led off the inning with a triple down the right field line and into the corner. And Josh Evans drawing the four-pitch walk. So it'll be Skyler Black who struck out to lead off the second inning. Batting from the stretch. First pitch to Black. It's a fastball in there for strike one. Excuse me, it's 2-1 now. Ground ball to short. DePreta Johnson flips it to Fitzgerald for one. Over to first for the double play. Huskies will trade the run for that. SFA on the board. It's 4-1.
Second baseman, number 3, Eric DeJesus.
So the base is empty with two outs for Eric DeJesus. Swung at the first pitch. Flying out to left his first time up. Takes a strike on the outer edge for strike one. Batten misses with the off-speed pitch, 1-1. Low and away, 2-1. DeJesus swings and misses. Even the count. Two pitch outside. The count is full. Batten winds and delivers. Down and in for ball four.
The shortstop, number 13, Manny Vasquez.
Now it'll be Manny Vasquez, who singled his first time up back in the second inning. Fastball for strike one. Line drive into center. That'll fall in front of Dukoff for a base hit. DeJesus will pull into second.
The catcher, number 23, Jared Hoover.
Now two runners on again with two outs. Beat the catcher, Jared Hoover. Hoover grounded out to second to end the second. First pitch, a foul ball to the right side. Jones over near the dugout. Nearly makes a great catch, but couldn't come up with it. Had to slide right in front of the railing in front of the Lumberjacks dugout on the first base side. Jones nearly made a spectacular play. He got to the ball, but just couldn't hold on to it. So it's 0-1 on Hoover. High for ball one. Pitches in there. 1-2 on Hoover. Batting with a look in. Comes set. Checks the runner at second. 1-2 pitch. In there for strike three. Batting. Gets Hoover looking. And the Lumberjacks leave a pair on here in the fourth. We go to the bottom half, HBU 4, SFA 1, here on the Husky Sports Network.
International Brotherhood of Building Houston to compete on the world stage is what we do at the IBEW. It's important to us that Houston knows why we do what we do, not just what we do. Sure, we're the best electricians. We train 10,000 hours to be the best. But we get up early so Houston is built to compete. To be the best, hire the best. Skilled labor isn't cheap, and cheap labor just isn't all that skilled.
The time is now to hire IBEW electricians.
At Memorial Hermann, we're many parts working in harmony. performing more brain and spinal surgeries than anyone in Houston. Conducting groundbreaking research at our Mischer Neuroscience Institute. Establishing the region's largest network of certified stroke centers. Some might say this makes for an accomplished performance, but to us, it's all in a day's work. Memorial Hermann. Breakthroughs every day.
Third baseman number 36, Elijah Simone.
Elijah Simone to lead it off against Trevor Kaminsky here in the bottom of the fourth inning. Huskies leading it 4-1 now. Lumberjacks getting on the board in the top half of the frame. Simone with a two-run double, his first time up back in the first inning. Takes ball one outside. That was low and away, 2-0. Fastball back to the screen. Strike call, 3-1 on Simone. That is called strike two. At the knees on the outer edge. Count goes full. Swinging a foul tip into the mitt. Simone goes down swinging. It's the first strikeout for Kaminsky.
First baseman number 38, Kerry Jones.
Then we have Kerry Jones. Popped up to third to end the first inning. Kaminsky misses high with ball one. Strike on the outside corner. The 1-1. And a slider on the inside corner for strike two. Kaminsky with the pitch. And a swing and a miss. Back-to-back strikeouts here for the Lumberjacks right-hander.
Second baseman number 10, Jack Fitzgerald.
Here's Jack Fitzgerald. Two outs and nobody on. Grounded out to third, his first time up. Swings and misses at strike one. Slider down and in, 1-1. Driven into deep right center field. Miner on the run, and he won't get there. It's off the base of the wall. Fitzgerald is into second with a stand-up double. Jack Fitzgerald with his second double of the season.
Tyler DePreda Johnson.
And brings up the top of the order again, and Tyler DePreda Johnson. It's 1-for-1, walked and scored in the first inning. Infield single in the second. Nobody's holding Fitzgerald on, so getting a big lead off of second, Kaminsky steps off. Driven to left, Martin back, and he won't get there. Off the wall, and Fitzgerald scores easily. DePreta Johnson into second with a double. The Huskies lead at 5-1.
Center fielder number 27, Jonathan Dukoff.
11 doubles now for DePreta Johnson. 28 RBIs on the season. It brings up Jonathan Dukoff, who is 1-for-2. RBI double and scored in the first inning. Grounded into a double play in the second. Swing at the first pitch and fouls it away. The 0-1 pitch is a slider, swung on and missed. Dukoff behind in the count. Strike three on the outside corner at the knees, but the Huskies get back-to-back doubles from Fitzgerald and DePreta Johnson. Now lead at 5-1 as we go to the fifth here on the Husky Sports Network.
You just hit the flavor motherlode. Guaranteed delicious. Firehouse subs are packed beyond belief with steaming hot premium meats and cheeses. Starting at only $5.49, it's gourmet subs without the gourmet prices. Just look at our club on the sub. And by look, he means try. Smoked turkey breast, Virginia honey ham, melty Monterey Jack, and bacony bacon.
Firehouse subs.
Starting at only $5.49. One bite, one taste, you're hooked.
Here's a toast to all you Caniacs. You are ever faithful aficionados of premium, fresh, never ever frozen chicken fingers from Raising Cane's. Keen connoisseurs of Cane's crispy, extra long, premium crinkle cut fries. You who are dedicated to the made fresh daily Cane sauce that twirls tongues in a tastefully tangy tango. Topped off with a little slice of heaven from the goodness of the griddle. We toast you all from Raising Cane's. One love.
Josh Campbell to lead it off for Stephen F. Austin. In the top of the fifth inning against Brady Batten. Campbell singled to lead off the third inning. Fastball low, it's 1-0. Fastball, don't know exactly where it missed. Call the ball, and it's 2-0. Fouled out of play, 2-1. That's high for ball three. Down and in, a leadoff walk to Campbell.
Center fielder number two, Nick Miner.
Let's go, guys. Come back to the top of the order with Nick Minor. Minor 0 for 1, hit by a pitch in the first inning. Grounded into a double play in the third. Takes a fastball for a strike. That's up high for a ball. Runner goes, chopper to short. DePreta Johnson gloves it, throws to first for the first out. Campbell into second since he was on the move.
Third baseman, number 26, Jake Georgiadis.
Here is Jake Georgiadis. 0 for 2 today, struck out in the first inning. Flying out to center in the third. Slider for a strike. Marshall Heron getting warmed up in the Huskies bullpen. The 0-1 and a foul out of play. Matthew McCullough was on a pitch count yesterday. Brady might be on one as well today. Down low, and it's 1-2. It's a good pitch by Batten, though, even though it was a ball. Nice breaking pitch that just was a little bit low. Trying to get the batter to chase that one. One, two. That one must have been a little low. That evens the count. The 80th pitch for Batten. So I'm 45 for strikes. Fastball low. The count goes full once again. Payoff pitch on the way. Georgiadis swings and misses for out number two. Brings up Jared Martin. Martin tripled the lead off the fourth inning.
Left fielder number 33, Jared Martin.
Scored when Skylar Black grounded into a double play to account for the lone run for the Lumberjacks. Takes pitch down low, 1-0. A strike called. On it. Patton sets, checks the runner at second. A 1-1 on the way. Popped up on the right side. Jones moving over. He has room. Makes the catch for the third out. We are halfway home here in the regular season finale. Huskies lead at 5-1 as we go to the bottom of the fifth here on the Husky Sports Network.
If you drive around in Texas, dude, you could be a polluter, and that's just rude. But there's a way to help keep the air clean. Gotta take care of your machine. It's the one with wheels, speedometer. This message goes out to both the sexes. Take care of your car, drive clean across Texas. Keep your engine tuned, keep air in the tires. Make friends with a mechanic, that's a guy with pliers. Please don't speed, that pollutes to the max. Don't sit there and idle, turn it off, relax. Read the paper, meditate. Combine errands if you can. Carpool, fill up with gas after dark when it's cool. If you see some car spitting out smoke, they're messing with the air, and that's no joke. The message is simple, it shouldn't perplex us. Take care of your car, drive clean across Texas. Doesn't matter if you drive a Ford or a Lexus. Take care of your car, drive clean across Texas. Brought to you by the Texas Department of Transportation and the Texas Natural Resource Conservation Commission. Drive clean across Texas.
Spencer Halloran.
Hey, Spencer Halloran to lead it off against Trevor Kaminsky here in the bottom of the fifth inning. Spencer's 0-2, lined out to second in the first inning, flied out to right in the third. Huskies leading at 5-1. After scoring four runs in the bottom of the first, a chopper to the left side, George Adas coming in. The throw just in time to get Halloran.
Designated hitter number 5, Matt Heck.
So the Huskies scored four in the bottom of the first. Lumberjack scored in the top of the fourth, and the Huskies answered that run, lead at 5-1, and here is Matt Heck. One out and the base is empty. Matt, 0-1 today. Walked and scored in the first inning. Grounded out to third in the third. There's a line drive over the head of DeJesus and into right center field for a base hit.
The catcher, number 40, Jake Pulshon.
There's Jake Pulshon with the runner on at first and one down. Jake has walked both times, has been up once in the first, once in the third. Pitch is in, signed for a ball. 80th pitch of the game for Kaminsky. Action in the Lumberjacks bullpen again. Right-hander is Tracen Cubo. Runner bluffs and a gets past Huber, and the wild pitch will move Heck up to second. 2-0 on Pulshon. The 2-0 pitch. Pulshon drills this one deep to left, and that one is way out of here. A home run for Jake Pulshon gives the Huskies a 7-1 lead. An absolute bomb from Jake Pulshon. It's going to be the fourth home run of the season for Jake. RBIs number 29 and 30, and that's going to be it for Kaminsky. Talking about the new pitcher for the Lumberjacks when we come back here on the Husky Sports Network.
does it mean to be Southland Strong?
It's not just big wins.
It's success in the classroom.
And being engaged with service.
Family.
Passion.
Integrity.
Overcoming adversity.
Hard work and dedication.
Bettering people around you.
Striving for excellence.
Leadership and competition.
On our campuses.
And in our communities.
We are Southland Strong.
If Raising Cane's one love was rock music, they would rock harder than any rock band ever. Their tours would sell out before they were announced. Their backstage parties would be the stuff of legend, attended by unicorns and the head of Louis XIV. Hotel rooms would trash themselves out of respect. But Raising Cane's one love isn't rock music. It's making the perfect chicken finger meal every single time. Raising Cane's one love.
New pitcher into the game for Stephen F. Austin is junior right-hander Trayson Kubo. 6 foot, 171 pounds from Waipahu, Hawaii. Making his 24th appearance. 0-2 with a 4.91 ERA. He's given up 19 runs, 16 earned on 34 hits. 31 strikeouts, 29 walks, 29 and one-third innings. Final line on Kaminsky. 7 runs all earned on 7 hits. 3 strikeouts, 4 walks, and 4 and a third innings.
Right fielder number 1, Anthony Jones.
Here is Anthony Jones. 0 for 2. He reached on a fielder's choice in the first inning. Drove in a run and scored. And grounded out to short to end the third. Here is Kubo, seeing him for the first time this series. Here's his first pitch to Anthony Jones. The fastball swung on and missed. Swing and a miss, 0-2. Up and away, 1-2. Top of the ninth in Abilene, Texas A&M Corpus Christi. Throwing down the ante. 10-3, top of the ninth inning. Looks like the Islanders going to put themselves at 14 wins. There's a foul back ahead of everyone else with 13. Bottom of the eighth inning in New Orleans. UNO leading Northwestern State 8-0. That's going to put the Demons into a tie with the Huskies and Central Arkansas for third place. 1-2 pitch, up and away, 2-2. Northwestern State and New Orleans playing a doubleheader today, so that game will factor in heavily to the seeding at the Southland Conference Tournament next week. Two-two pitch to Jones. Foul tip. Swung on and missed into the mitt. So second out.
Baseman number 36, Elijah.
A strikeout for Kubo. And now to bring up Elijah Simone. 2-run double in the first. Struck out to lead off the fourth inning. Takes a fastball in the inside corner for a strike. Nichols leading Central Arkansas 2-0 in the bottom of the fifth in Thibodeau. Swing and a miss, and it's 0-2. Sam Houston State leading Incarnate Word 5-3, top of the sixth inning in San Antonio. McNeese and Lamar tied up 1-1, bottom of the second in Beaumont. And strike 3 called at the knees. And Kubo gets out of the inning. The Huskies add 2 more on the two-run homer by Jake Fulshon, lead at 7-1 going to the sixth here on the Husky Ben's Sports Network.
The real story is I'm in here every morning and have sampled just about every kolache that they make here.
Bacon, egg, and cheese on wheat for me, and then the rest is for the office. So, yes, I'll pick up every Friday. I'll stop by here and pick up some for my groups.
Well, I used to think it was just fruit-filled stuff, and then I came here, and there's eggs and bacon and cheese and all kinds of good stuff in there. It's like a whole breakfast and a bun. It's great.
It's always a good thing if you can eat healthy and not know it.
When you drive down the street looking for something to eat, you're going to pass 5 places to buy a sandwich, 6 places to buy a burger. There's only one place you can get a kolache, and that's Kolache Factory. It's delicious. You're going to have people that try to copy you, but they're not going to do it as well. We know what we're doing. We've been doing it for 25 years. We do it the best, and our success proves that.
Houston's own Kolache Factory, the freshest, highest quality, best tasting kolaches in town. Over 50 Houston area locations and a proud partner of HBU Athletics.
Tammy and I have been going steady since high school.
Tammy and Tommy, two peas in a pod, as they say.
We have all the same friends.
Brady Vatten back out there for the sixth inning for HBU. We'll be facing Josh Evans, Skylar Black, and Eric DeJesus. 4-5 and 6-2 up for SFA.
First baseman, number 17, Josh Evans.
Ball one low to Evans. 0-1 today, grounded out to third in the first inning, walked in the fourth. Two and oh now. Swing and a miss. It's 2-1. Swing and a miss for strike two. Be the 90th pitch coming up for Batten. Popped up on the left side. That will be caught by Simone right in front of his teammates in the third base dugout for out number one.
Designated hitter number 30, Skylar Black.
Here is Skylar Black. It's 0-2, struck out to lead off the second. Grounded into a double play in the fourth. Takes strike one in the outside corner. Slider swung on and missed, 0-2. That skips in front of home plate, 1-2. Up and in, almost hit Black, but he turned away. That'll even the count. Patton winds and delivers. And that's low. 3-2. Payoff pitch coming up. And on the inside corner at the knees, Black strikes out for out number two.
Second baseman number 3, Eric DeJesus.
So here is Eric DeJesus. 0-1 today Flied out the left in the second, walked in the fourth. Picked strike one. Pitches just a little bit outside, 1-1. Looked like a pretty good pitch there. Called the ball. Outside ball three. That's 100 pitches now for Batten. 55 for strikes. I have no idea where the strike zone is.
The shortstop, number 13, Manny Vasquez.
The two-out walk issued to DeJesus brings up Manny Vasquez. Vasquez, 2-for-2, a single in the second, single in the fourth. Pops it up. Pulsion trying to find it, but it'll just get over the screen for a foul ball and strike one. One pitch. Slider misses high. 1-1. Inside. 2-1. High fly ball to left. Halloran there. He will make the catch for the third out. We go to the bottom of the sixth. Huskies 7, Lumberjacks 1 here on the Husky Sports Network.
Excuse me, is that your Diet Pepsi?
Sofia Vergara. This is my Diet Pepsi. I love Diet Pepsi.
Do you love every sip?
Nothing is better than drinking a refreshing Diet Pepsi and just reveling in its crisp, delicious taste.
Well, you know what they say. If you love something, let it go. And if it comes back, it was meant to be.
So I should set this Diet Pepsi free and wait for it to come back. Then it'll be more delicious than ever. Would you hold my Diet Pepsi for me?
I'd love to.
Thank you. What happens now?
Go, get out of here. It can't come back to you if you're standing next to it.
Thanks, Sophia. I'll wait for you, Diet Pepsi!
The only thing better than an ice-cold Diet Pepsi is a free ice-cold Diet Pepsi.
Love every sip at DietPepsi.com.
Russ Renault welcoming you back here to Husky Field in Houston. The regular season and Southland Conference finale between HBU and Stephen F. Austin right here on the Husky Sports Network. Huskies leading it 7-1 as we go to the bottom of the sixth inning.
The first baseman, number
Trace Incubo back
Perry
out there
Jones.
For the Lumberjacks. Came in relief last inning. Facing Kerry Jones to lead it off. Carry 0-for-2, popped up to third to end the first inning, struck out in the fourth. Fastball lifted into left field. Martin will make the catch for the first out. I'm going to bring up Jack Fitzgerald.
Second baseman number 10, Jack Fitzgerald.
Jack 1-for-2, grounded out to third in the second inning. Doubled and scored in the fourth. Kubo misses high for ball one. That's up and away, 2-0. Fouled off, 2-1 to Fitzgerald. Fastball low, 3-1. Down low, ball four. Fitzgerald draws a one-out walk to get us back to the top of the order in Tyler DePreta Johnson. Tyler is 2-for-2.
Shortstop number 3, Tyler DePreta Johnson.
Walked and scored in the first inning, singled in the second, and an RBI double in the fourth. More action in the bullpen for the Lumberjacks. Right-hander Josh Ponder. First pitch up and in. It actually grazed him. So a hit by pitch.
Center fielder number 27, Jonathan Dukoff.
Now to bring up Jonathan Dukoff. One for three, an RBI double, and scored in the first inning. Grounded out to second to end the second, struck out to end the fourth. Two on and one out here in the sixth. Driven deep to left, and that ball is out of here. A three-run home run for Jonathan Dukoff, and the Huskies lead it 10-1. Home run number 8 of the season for Dukoff.
Left fielder number 14.
He's got 4 RBIs today. Give him 24 for the season. A double and a home run today. And brings up Spencer Halloran. Fastball low, 1-0. Halloran fouls that one off, and it's 1-1. Huskies 4 runs in the first inning, then 1-2-3. 1 in the fourth, 2 in the fifth, and 3 here in the sixth. Off-speed pitch, swung on and missed, 1-2. Two home runs for HBU today, giving them 52. On the season. That leads the Southland Conference the most by an HBU team since joining Division I play in 2007. 1-2 pitch to Halloran is up high. And speaking of home runs, Halloran will be representing HBU in the first ever Southland Conference Home Run Derby to start off the Southland Conference Tournament festivities. That's Tuesday night at Constellation Field. Free admission out there for the Home Run Derby. 2-2 pitch. Halloran with a high fly ball to center. Miner is under it. Makes the catch for the second out. So if you want some free fun next Tuesday night,
designated hitter number 5.
Each of the eight teams in the Southland Conference Tournament will have a representative in the Home Run Derby, and Spencer will be doing that for HBU. Here is Matt Heck. Matt 1-for-2. Walked and scored in the first inning. Grounded out to third in the third and singled and scored in the fifth. Kubo spikes a fastball. It's 1-0. Fouled away, 1-1. One fastball is in there for strike two. One-two pitch. Swung on and missed. Kubo gets a strikeout, but the Huskies strike three more times. 10-1 as we go to the seventh here on the Husky Sports Network.
The body is incredibly powerful. It's so nimble and fluid. But sometimes we push it too far. That's when you need the strength of Memorial Hermann and our body of affiliated orthopedic specialists. With our renowned Ironman Sports Medicine Institute, they not only get your body back to where it was, they get it to go further. It's what makes us more than just hospitals. We are a body of experts. Memorial Hermann, advancing health. Medicine Institute at Texas Medical.
Please, now pitching for the Huskies, number 26, Tennessee.
Is it time to buy your first or next car? Let Houston Federal Credit Union help. Their super low rates and easy payment terms can save you a lot of money. Plus, their fast approval will put you behind the wheel of your dream car in no time. Stop by their office near campus at 6808 Bentliff Drive or visit them online at HoustonFCU.org and let them help you get the very best deal on your new or pre-owned car or truck. Experience a better way of banking at Houston Federal Credit Union, the official credit union of HBU.
Houston Federal Credit Union is federally insured by NCUA.
New pitcher into the game for the Huskies is senior right-hander Tanner Luna. Tanner making his sixth appearance on the season. No record. 9.82 ERA. He's given up four runs on two hits. No strikeouts, eight walks, and three and two-thirds innings. Tanner, 6'1", 185 pounds, from Caldwell High School. So getting some work here on senior day.
Lumberjacks and pitch hitting.
I have a pinch hitter,
John Santos,
for the Lumberjacks. Batting for the catcher, Huber, is John Santos. First pitch is up high for ball one. Santos hitting 105. 4 for 38 on the season with one RBI, two runs scored. Ball inside, and it's 3-0. Down and in, and a four-pitch walk. Saw Santos yesterday, pinch hit,
Josh Campbell.
Struck out, and is only at bat of the series so far, and that was the second at bat. Go to Josh Campbell. Campbell 1-for-1, singled in the third inning, walked in the fifth. Luna fires a strike. Inside for ball one. Popped up on the right side, and Fitzgerald can't make the play. It's a fair ball. Throws to second for the force out. So it goes down as a fielder's choice. Fielder's choice, and the out at second. So there's one down here in the seventh inning.
Center fielder number two, Nick Miner.
Can't blame Santos. He had to hold up to see if Fitzgerald was going to come up with that, and he almost did. And if Santos had left early, Fitzgerald, if he caught it, would have doubled him up at first, but had no choice. So Campbell reaches on the fielder's choice, and it's inside to Miner and hits him. So two on and one out for Jake Georgiadis. He's 0 for 3 today.
Jake Georgiadis.
Struck out in the first inning, flying out to center to end the third, and struck out in the fifth. So Campbell at second, Miner at first. Strike on the inside corner. Swing and a miss, and it's 0-2. Luna sets at the belt. And a breaking ball skips in front of Pulshawn. A wild pitch will move the runners up. One-two pitch, fly ball to left, Halloran on the run, and he will make the catch. Runners will tag. That'll make it 10-2, and there's two down. Sack fly for Georgiadis. Campbell scores, Miner to third. Have another pinch hitter. For the Lumberjacks.
For the Lumberjacks, number 25, Cody Williams.
Be Cody Williams pinch hitting for Jared Martin. Williams, a sophomore from Pearland, Pearland High School. Takes ball one low. Williams started yesterday's game, went 1-for-2 and scored a run. It's inside and it's 2-0. Number off the end of the bat and towards Luna. We'll shovel it to first. That'll be the third out. SFA scores one. And we go to the seventh inning stretch, HBU 10 and SFA 2 here on the Husky Sports Network.
Look, someone left their magical lamp behind.
Greetings. I am the super magical genie of the lamp. I'm here to grant you any wish you'd like. With the exception of more wishes, eternal life, or property tax advice.
Okay, I want a refreshing cola with less sugar and real cola taste.
Seriously? That's it?
Yeah, that would be unbelievable.
Well, it already exists. It's called Pepsi Next. It has real cola taste and 60% less sugar. It's delicious. Plus, you can find it almost anywhere. You don't understand, my dear. I can do anything. I can give you X-ray vision. Or an island made of jelly beans. Or how about a condo in outer space?
You're right. I should think bigger.
Yes, much bigger.
Can I have an ice-cold Pepsi Next in a huge glass?
They call that last pitch a foul ball. So it's 2-1. Now it's 3-1 to Williams. Swing and a miss. A foul tip, and the count goes full. Okay, that pitch is inside, ball four. The worst thing about that is it was called so late. Everybody was off the field. And then after about a minute, he said, oh, wait, that was a foul ball. First and it was just, everybody was already off the field. So now here is Josh Evans. The runner's at first and third. Now a pop-up, and Pulshawn dives but can't get there. Evans 0 for 2, grounded out to third in the first inning. Walked in the fourth and fouled out to third to lead off the sixth. And then the strike zone gets smaller. It's 1-1. Ground ball to second. Jack Fitzgerald over to first. And that will end the inning now. Now we can go to the seventh inning stretch. All Huskies right, leading 10-2 on the Husky Sports Network. And get loose.
The real story is I'm in here every morning and have sampled just about every kolache that they make here.
Bacon, egg, and cheese on wheat for me, and then the rest is for the office. So, yes, I'll pick up every Friday. I'll stop by here and pick up some for my group. So.
Well, I used to think it was just fruit-filled stuff, and then I came here, and there's eggs and bacon and cheese and all kinds of good stuff in there. It's like a whole breakfast and a bun. It's great.
It's always a good thing if you can eat healthy and not know it.
When you drive down the street looking for something to eat, you're going to pass 5 places to buy a sandwich, 6 places to buy a burger. There's only one place you can get a kolache, and that's Kolache Factory. It's delicious. You're going to have people that try to copy you, but they're not going to do it as well. We know what we're doing. We've been doing it for 25 years. We do it the best, and our success proves that.
Houston's own Kolache Factory, the freshest, highest quality, best tasting kolaches in town. Over 50 Houston area locations and a proud partner of HBU Athletics.
Tammy and I have been going steady since high school.
Tammy and Tommy, two peas in a pod, as they say.
We have all the same friends. We like all the same things. I mean, we practically even have the same name.
But there's one thing we could just never agree on.
Soda.
I have been begging him all these years to just try Pepsi, and I knew he would change his tune.
Yeah, yeah.
So, finally, I had him take the Pepsi Taste Challenge. And go on, tell him what you told me, Tommy.
I'm a Pepsi man. Mm.
That shortstop. Moving to shortstop, number 3, Eric DeJesus. Pitching for the Lumberjacks, number 40, Josh Ponder. Leading off for the Huskies, number 40, the catcher, Jake Pochon.
New pitcher into the game for the Lumberjacks is sophomore right-hander Josh Ponder from McKinney, Texas, and McKinney High School. Ponder making his 21st appearance. Low and away to Jake Pulshawn. 0-3 with a 9.64 ERA. One save. He's given up 34 runs, 30 earned on 38 hits. 14 strikeouts, 12 walks, 28 innings. And Jake fouls that one off, and it's 1-1. New left fielder is Cody Williams. Luis Santiago now catching. Pitches low and away. 2-1. Jake 1-for-1 today. 2-run homer his last time up. Back in the 5th inning. Skies this one to center. Miner is there. Makes the catch. Jake had walked his other 2 times up. Flies out here for the first out.
Right fielder number 2, Jake Scott.
Here is Jake Scott. Came in as a defensive replacement. Fouls off the first pitch. A fly ball to center. Miner there makes the catch for out number 2.
Third baseman number 36, Elijah Simone.
Here's Elijah Simone, takes ball 1 high. Eli 1-for-3, 2-run double in the first inning. Struck out in the 4th, then again in the 5th. Drives this one to left. Williams there, makes a catch in a 1-2-3 inning. We go to the 8th, HBU 10, SFA 2 here on the Husky Sports Network.
Travel isn't what it used to be. By the time you get where you're going, you've been through it all. So what if you knew there was a hotel that understands how hard your journey's been and spends all its time making up for it? At DoubleTree by Hilton, with more than 325 wonderful destinations around the world, we welcome our guests with a warm chocolate chip cookie. Our cookie serves as a symbol of our commitment to turn every little detail of your stay into a delight, preparing every comfort with care, making every touch special and every gesture true, giving that extra attention to the simple things, bringing humanity back to business and leisure travel so you can reconnect, relax, play, focus, smile. Welcome to DoubleTree by Hilton, where the little things mean everything.
For camera ID Copeland.
New pitcher into the game for HBU, senior right-hander Cameron Copeland, 6'2", 205 from Plano, Texas. Get Cameron's numbers here in a second. Cameron making his 10th appearance, 1-0 with a 5.73 ERA. He's given up 7 runs on 12 hits, 8 strikeouts, 2 walks, and 11 innings. And Cameron came in yesterday in the 9th inning, threw 5 pitches in a 1-2-3 ninth. Looks like we're going to have a pinch hitter for the Lumberjacks as well. It's going to be Antonio Lima, junior from Grapevine, Texas. Lumberjacks
and pinch hitting number 4, Antonio Lima.
He replaces Skyler Black. The DH spot in the 5 hole. So Lima, junior from Grapevine, and he is hitting .222 on the year, 4 for 18 with 3 RBIs, a double, 4 runs scored. Here is Cameron Copeland. His first pitch on the way is in there for strike one. One other change defensively for the Huskies, Jeremy Simone, twin brother of third baseman Elijah Simone, is now catching. Redshirt freshman from Angleton in Brazosport Christian High School. Elijah played last year. Jeremy did not see any action his first year, so Elijah is a sophomore, Jeremy a redshirt freshman. 0-2 the count on Lima. Copeland with the pitch, and a fastball in the outside corner for strike three. That'll bring up Eric DeJesus. DeJesus is 0 for 1. Flied out to left in the second. Walked his other two times up, once in the fourth, once in the sixth. Fastball just misses low. 1-0. Same spot, 2-0. Chopper foul. It was a fly ball to right. Scott went back at first and found it. Made the catch for the second out.
Pitch hitter number 1, Tyler Kimball.
Another pinch hitter for the Lumberjacks. Place of the shortstop, Manny Vasquez. Be Tyler Kimball. Kimball Jr. from Pearland. Takes a ball outside from Copeland. Kimball has seen action in both games, the pinch hitter. 0 for 1 yesterday, 0 for 1 on Thursday. Fouls that one away, 1 and 1. Two down in the top of the eighth inning. Huskies on top of the Lumberjacks, 10 to 2. Breaking ball. And that just misses, 2 and 1. Popped up into left field. Halloran coming in. Halloran making the catch for the third out. Another 1-2-3 inning for Cameron Copeland. We go to the bottom of the eighth. HBU 10, SFA 2, on Husky Sports Network.
Car insurance to HBU alumni, just visit geico.com/mydiscount to get a free quote and mention you're an HBU alum.
Are you a graduate of Houston Baptist University? Did you know the value of your degree increases when you actively participate in the HBU Alumni Association? Your Alumni Association actively supports the growth, retention, and ranking of our school by our scholarship efforts. Husky Alumni Network volunteers actively work to recruit the best and brightest to HBU, and we promote and support programs intended to build a growing network of people committed to quality, higher Christian education through our alumni scholarship efforts. We also work to strengthen the bond between our university and the community, and we're your connection to over 18,000 fellow alumni, mostly in and around the Houston metro area. Log on to learn more about our mission and your privileges and benefits at hbu.edu/alumni. And find us via social media on Facebook at the Houston Baptist University Alumni Association page and on Twitter and Instagram at @HBU_alumni. But no matter how you do it, connect with the HBU Alumni Association, because a strong alumni base equals a strong HBU.
New pitcher into the game for Stephen F. Austin is senior right-hander Cole Ridgely, 5'8 from Marble Falls, Texas. Ridgely making his 26th appearance, 1-4, 9.31 ERAs. He has one save. He's given up 35 runs, 30 earned on 50 hits with 23 strikeouts, 16 walks, and 29 innings. Also defensively for the Lumberjacks, Tyler Kimball staying in to play shortstop. So be Kerry Jones to lead it off for the Huskies. And a new center fielder as well.
Being off for the Huskies, the first baseman, number 38, Kerry Jones.
The new center fielder is Kyle Cullen. Jones with a deep fly ball to left. That ball is back. That ball is deep, and it's gone! A solo home run for Kerry Jones on Senior Day, and that makes it 11-2 Huskies. Home run number 2 of the season for Kerry Jones. Home run number 7 of his career, and I believe he was pointing at his brother Curtis, who was seated down the left field line as he rounded the bases. Curtis, a 4-year letter winner here for HBU. 2-time Southland Conference Utility Player of the Year. 0-1 count on Fitzgerald. That one's low and away for ball 1. Jack 1-for-2, grounded out to third in the second inning, doubled and scored in the fourth, and walked and scored in the sixth. Down and in, 2-1. Talking about Ridgely, the new pitcher. There's a line drive into center field, a base hit for Fitzgerald. Goes to the new center fielder, Kyle Cullen. And brings up Tyler DePreta Johnson.
The shortstop, number 3, Tyler DePreta Johnson.
Three home runs today for the Huskies. One by Jonathan Dukoff. One by Jake Pulshon, and one by Kerry Jones. Runner on and nobody out. Pitch misses high, and it's 1-0. Kerry Jones making it 11-2 here in the bottom of the eighth inning. Popped up, a high fly ball to left. Williams coming in with the shortstop. Kimball going back, and he makes the catch in shallow left center for the first out.
Center fielder, number 27, Jonathan Dukoff.
And here is Jonathan Dukoff. Huge day for him, 2-for-4. RBI double and scored in the first inning. Grounded out to second in the second, struck out in the fourth, and then a 3-run home run in the sixth. So 13 doubles, 8 home runs, 24 driven in for Jonathan now on the season. And a breaking ball misses high, 1-0. Low and away, and a wild pitch back to the screen. That'll move Fitzgerald up to second. Eleven runs, 10 hits for HBU, 2 runs on 5 hits for SFA. Fitzgerald now at second. Driven deep to left, and that ball is way out of here. And that is a walk-off home run. That's a run rule, and that'll do it. Huskies win this one by a score of 13-2 on the 2-run home run by Jonathan Dukoff. Everybody's standing around looking. The ball game's over. It's the last game of the series. That's the run rule. 2 home run day for Jonathan Dukoff, and the Huskies win it by a score of 13-2. We will come back and wrap it up here on the Husky Sports Network.
Huskies win.
As the Huskies sweep the series here on the final day of the regular season.
Be sure and catch the Huskies at the Southland Conference.
We know travel isn't what it used to be. By the time you get where you're going, you've been through it all. So what if you knew there was a hotel that understands how hard your journey's been and spends all its time making up for it? At DoubleTree by Hilton, with more than 325 wonderful destinations around the world, we welcome our guests with a warm chocolate chip cookie. Our cookie serves as a symbol of our commitment to turn every little detail of your stay into a delight. Preparing every comfort with care, making every touch special, and every gesture true. Giving that extra attention to the simple things. Bringing humanity back to business and leisure travel. So you can reconnect, relax, play, focus, smile. Welcome to DoubleTree by Hilton. Where the little things mean everything.
The real story is I'm in here every morning. And have sampled just about every kolache that they make here.
Bacon, egg, and cheese on wheat for me, and then the rest is for the office. So, yes, I'll pick up every Friday. I'll stop by here and pick up some for my group. So.
Well, I used to think it was just fruit-filled stuff, and then I came here, and there's eggs and bacon and cheese and all kinds of good stuff in there. It's like a whole breakfast and a bun. It's great.
It's always a good thing if you can eat healthy and not know it.
When you drive down the street looking for something to eat, you're going to pass 5 places to buy a sandwich, 6 places to buy a burger. There's only one place you can get a kolache, and that's Kolache Factory. It's delicious. You're going to have people that try to copy you, but they're not going to do it as well. We know what we're doing. We've been doing it for 25 years. We do it the best, and our success proves that.
Houston's own Kolache Factory, the freshest, highest quality, best tasting kolaches in town. Over 50 Houston area locations and a proud partner of HBU Athletics.
Tammy and I have been going steady since high school.
Tammy and Tommy, two peas in a pod, as they say.
We have all the same friends. We like all the same things. I mean, we practically even have the same name.
But there's one thing we could just never agree on.
Soda.
I have been begging him all these years to just try Pepsi, and I knew he would change his tune.
Yeah, yeah.
So, finally, I had him take the Pepsi Taste Challenge. And go on, tell him what you told me, Tommy.
I'm a Pepsi man. Mmm.
Right? Gosh, isn't Pepsi so good?
I tell you what, I don't know why I didn't try it sooner.
Me neither.
It's so crisp and refreshing and bubbly.
Like me.
Like you.
I'm always right.
She's always right.
All across the South, people are choosing the great taste of Pepsi. Take the Pepsi Taste Challenge and let your taste decide.
Russ Reno back here at Husky Field. HBU sweeping the three-game Southland Conference Series over Stephen F. Austin. A final score of 13-2 here on Saturday in 8 innings. A run roll coming on the what it proved to be a walk-off home run by Jonathan Dukoff, his second of the day. So here are the final totals for the Huskies. Now 26-28 overall on the season, 18-12 in the Southland. So Lee's clinching a tie for third place. Don't know how the seeding is going to shake out, though. We'll get to the Southland Conference scoreboard here in a second. SFA falling to 17-36 on the season, 9-21, and they will not be advancing to the Southland Conference tournament. Final totals, Huskies 13 runs on 11 hits. Stephen F. Austin, 2 runs on 5 hits, no errors on either side. Brady Batten gets the win, goes to 4-6 on the year, 1 run on 5 hits. 5 strikeouts, 4 walks in 6 innings. Tanner Luna giving up 1 run, 2 walks in 1 inning pitch, and then Cameron Copeland. Another perfect inning, this time on 11 pitches. Losing pitcher Trevor Kaminsky, 7 runs on 7 hits. 3 strikeouts, 4 walks in 4 1/3 innings. Offensively for the Lumberjacks, Manny Vasquez went 2-for-3. Jared Martin 2-for-3 with a triple and scored the lone run in the game, scored a run for SFA, and Jake Georgiadis driving in a run for the Lumberjacks. For the Huskies, Jonathan Dukoff 3-for-5 with a double, 2 home runs, 6 RBIs and 3 runs scored. Jake Pulshon homer, drove in 2 and scored 1, and Matt Heck going 1-for-3, scoring twice. Tyler DePreta Johnson 2-for-3 with an RBI and 2 runs scored. And Jack Fitzgerald going 2-for-3 with a double, scoring 3 times. And Kerry Jones with a big shot in the to lead off the 8th inning, a solo home run. His only hit of the day, Elijah Simone, driving in a pair. So the Huskies win this one by a score of 13-2. And at least clinch a share of third place, but still keeping an eye on Northwestern State and Central Arkansas. It looks like Central Arkansas is about to lose to Nichols, so that would drop the Bears down into fourth. Northwestern State lost, so they're now 17-12. They have one more this afternoon at New Orleans. The Texas A&M Corpus Christi defeated Abilene Christian 10-3. New Orleans defeated Northwestern State 8-1. Sam Houston State is leading Incarnate Word 7-3 in the bottom of the eighth. Like I said, in the top of the ninth inning in Thibodeau, Nichols leading Central Arkansas 4-0. And Lamar leading McNeese 5-1 in the top of the fifth in Beaumont. McNeese knows where it's going to be. This game really doesn't matter for them. They are the sixth seed no matter what happens today. And then the game everybody's going to be watching later on, Northwestern State, is at New Orleans. I want to thank everybody for joining us here on the Husky Sports Network here on the final regular season Saturday. The Huskies will return to action at the Southland Conference Tournament on Wednesday. And check HBUHuskies.com to find out exactly when and who the Huskies will be playing. I'll be bringing the audio broadcast on the Legacy Sports Network. That's all we'll have next week, just the audio. And then Southland Conference will be handing the video broadcast. So I will be seeing all of you out at Sugarland at Constellation Field on Wednesday night. If you want to make the home run derby, come on, cheer on Spencer Halloran on Tuesday. Free admission. I just want to thank everybody for joining us here at Husky Field for the final Saturday of the regular season. It's a beautiful day. Now, Huskies with a win and a sweep, 13-2 here in the finale. Thanks, everybody. Enjoy the rest of your weekend.
The Husky Sports Network, powered by the Legacy Sports Network. These broadcasts are brought to you by the corporate sponsors of HBU Athletics, including Houston Federal Credit Union, the Memorial Hermann Healthcare System, Pepsi, GEICO, Raising Cane's, Kolache Factory, and IBEW Local 716. That's going to wrap it up for now. So until we see you next time, so long and dogs up.
This is the HBU Husky.